hands. You just tell me what you think, okay? So, what does that look like to you? Yeah. Anything else?
It's a pie chart.
A pie chart, I love that. Yes, it could be. What else? Okay, and I'm using this as an analogy, so I'm terrible at pictures. What does it look like? What is it beginning to look like? And I'll put some pepperoni on it. Pizza. Okay. So this is an analogy. So do anybody know what an analogy is? It's a way of talking about something really big in a very simple way. Does that make sense? Okay. So this, we're going to call this the gift. And this is the sliver. What's the difference between the two of them?
The sliver is what?
Yes, there's no pizza right there, right? Right? Okay, so tell me what's great. What does it feel like when you eat pizza? And you love it. What's it feel like? Give me some. What? Oh, okay. What else? Positive things. Things that you like about eating pizza.
Warm.
Yes. Okay. What else?
The crust.
What do you like about the crust?
It's crunchy.
Crunchy. Yeah. Yeah. What else?
Cheesy.
What kind of? What's your favorite kind of pizza?
Pepperoni.
Pepperoni? I got it. All right. What else? Who else like? What else is fun about eating pizza?
Greasy,
yes. And when you eat with people, is that fun? Is it more fun to eat pizza with people? No. Yes or no?
No.
You like to eat it by yourself?
No, I like to eat by myself.
Okay. All right. And then what is the sliver like? What happens if I gave you a plate of food and there was no pizza on it? What would you think about that? You don't care? What else? All right, so here you're getting no pizza, here you're getting pizza, okay? So this is something that we can use to talk about ourselves, others, and situations, okay? So if I am looking at, and I'm gonna take myself for example. When I was a kid, I was incredibly depressed, okay? I thought I was ugly, stupid, and just really the worst, okay? Where was I living? Here or here?
The sliver.
Why do you say that?
Because the sliver has nothing. The sliver is part of nothing.
Right. And I didn't have any friends back then either. Okay. So that's what I believed was the truth. It didn't look like this. My pie looked like this. I totally believed that I was a terrible person. That's just the way I was, okay? It was absolute fact. There was no disputing it. If anybody said anything nice to me, what do you think I said?
Never.
What?
Never.
Yes, they're lying. What else might they say, might I say? I might do that, yeah, and I might parry it. I would never allow a compliment to come into me. I would never accept it. I would never say thank you. I'd say, no, you know, like that, okay? So then fast forward, and I had an event when I was 13 where I was so upset. I mean, I was crying and by myself. You know, I had this wad of toilet paper and it was soaking wet and it was terrible. And I heard this sort of a spirit or a voice that said, you're gonna help many people. And I was like, oh, wow, okay. And then I went back. So fast forward, I've got four kids and we're sitting at the table and I'm telling, sit down, you do this, don't do that, don't do that. And all I had this epiphany. Do you know what an epiphany is?
An idea.
An idea, yes. Thank you so much for participating. I love that. And it was, I hate my children. Can you imagine a mom's thinking that about her children? It's awful. And yet when we get so stressed out, that's the way we feel. And I made a decision. I said, I'm going to say one nice thing to each of my children every day. What do you think happened the first day? Remember, I'm conditioned to only see the bad stuff about them. What do you think I thought that first day?
That there was nothing good to say.
Yes, yes, it was very, very hard. And that's because my brain here was wired back and forth, negative, 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 because I was still living in the sliver. So all I could think was negative things. So I looked at my daughter and I said, I like that shirt. And what do you think I was thinking inside? Yes! Yeah, what else? Yes, it was a lie. I thought a lie, but what did I say after that? I said, that's a lie, but I said it anyway. So what I did is I changed from the negative
to the positive.
Yes, awesome, yes. So here I did one positive thing. Now I did that every day for all of my children. What do you think happened over time?
They started skyrocketing.
Yes, so I started to have more positive and the negative did what? Faded away. That's right. Now I could still get caught into it. It was very easy to go back into this pattern, especially when I was having a tough day. Okay? But what happened is that there was another result that happened. So I'm saying this to my children. And what do you think? Now remember, I think that I'm the worst person in the world. What do you think happened as I was saying positive things to my children? Yes, that's right. I stopped being so hard on myself and I started to see some of the positive things. It was really life-changing. Now, instead of fighting at the table, we would all work together so that we could go and play. And we did things like we had ice cream for lunch. And all these sort of fun things, right? Because we were all working together to make it happen, all right? So let's talk a little bit. That's the story of how I figured this out, okay? So when we think of the gift, what are some things that are part of the gift?
Positive things,
positive statements. Yep, what else? Now, when you're having fun, what's happening when you're having fun? What makes things fun? Or when do you feel good? Sleeping, okay. Good sleep. How about laughter? Laughter, right? Good jokes. How about a meaningful conversation? Come on, you guys. Come on, what are some other things? Come on, take a risk. Okay, meaningful conversations. How about love? Love? Okay, what else? Caring for somebody else? Do you feel good when you care for somebody else?
Yeah.
So that would be empathy. That makes sense? Okay. So in the Living in the Gift program, there's three components. Okay? There's the mind, body, and the spirit. Okay? So what do you think this is? Sleep. What category is that going? Mind, body, or spirit?
Body.
Body, okay. So this is sleep. Okay, what else? How about laughter? Oops, wrong one.
Spirit.
Yes, it is. Because there's a connection there, right? Okay, so we're going to put laughter here. Okay. What about positive statements?
Mind,
yeah. All right, what else? Meaningful connections, what's that?
Spirit.
Gosh, you guys are great. Connections, we'll put connections. So does that mean that when you have friends and you're really connected, that that's a spiritual part of things?
Yeah,
that's right. So spirit is part of our everyday lives. Okay, how about love? What's that?
Love comes with the spirit.
Yes, yes. So which do you think is the most powerful at bringing about change and growth?
Spirit.
Yes.
Well, kind of, because also we need to be mindful about certain things. So I feel like it would be 50-50 between spirit.
Right, so you actually need all three, right? So that was a very good point. That's awesome. So when you're feeling laughter, what's happening in your body? When you're having, you know, just so happy, what's happening in your body?
You feel very euphoric.
Euphoric, yes. What else? Are you holding tension here?
No,
relax. Relax, yeah. And you're express
dopamine.
My gosh, look at that. So we've got relax. What'd you say?
Huh?
What did you say about what your body feels like?
Oh, you feel euphoric.
Euphoric, yeah. And you said dopamine, right? So yes, the body is squirting dopamine. And what does dopamine do for us? Makes you happy. Yep, what else?
And relaxed and like more like open.
Yes, and when you're open to more things, then what happens?
You try new things.
Try new things, you're smarter, you're more creative, and you're able to retrieve more information. Okay. So that's a pretty good thing, isn't it? So what do we have to do to get our dopamine levels up?
Do things that you like to do.
Yeah, yes. And we talked about some other things. Caring for others, right? That also does it. So when we live in the gift, we're opening the floodgates of joy and hope, laughter, euphoria, all those things that you said, right? And so when I learned this, I said, oh my gosh. Now I am a coach, I'm a life coach. Anybody know what a life coach is?
They coach you in how to get good things.
Yeah, Now that, what's the difference between a life coach and a therapist?
Was it that?
Yes. Very good. Thank you. And so where does this the therapist operate? That's the mind and the body. Well, mostly the mind, right? How about where does it? What is the therapist focused on? Right, feelings and thoughts, right?
Problems,
yes. So they're looking to solve problems. So I'm a coach, and I'm looking to help you folks do what?
Go through life.
Go through life, enjoy life, take your gifts and your talents and make them into reality, right? Now, I don't want to say, oh, that's stupid, right? I want to be saying, wow, that's amazing. Even if it's different from everybody else, because the fact that you're different is so awesome. It means that you're unique and that you've got something that's really important to share. Just like me, I felt like I was a real weirdo, okay? But this is what's come out of that, all right? Okay, so as a life coach, I help people live in the gift. I'm not necessarily helping them with their problems, but I'm helping them live in the gift. And what do you think the result is on some of their problems? They what?
It'll get fixed to an extent.
Why would that happen?
Because if someone is like going through life, and let's say their life gets better in a sense, then they'll start to forget about the bad things, or it'll help with the bad things, and then the story will get smaller and smaller and smaller.
You said it perfectly. Yes. 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 So when I work with people, I find their gifts and their talents, what interests them, and what that does is it helps them have more dopamine. It helps them feel safer, right? Because when you talk about someone's problems, I mean, I don't know about you, but I don't want anybody to see my shortcomings or my problems. But here, when we support each other, we become stronger together, okay? We've all got problems, we've all got shortcomings. But when we focus on the gift, we make life better for everyone and ourselves, just like me. I didn't know I was gonna feel better about myself when I said positive things about my children. Do you know that when I was living in the sliver with my children, people would come up to me and they'd say, oh, you have such difficult children. And then 2 years later, when I had done this for a while, they would come up to me and they would say, oh, you have such wonderful children. So just me committing to the positive changed me, it changed my children, and it changed everybody around me. It's very, very powerful, right? So where are we for time here? 10, is it 10:30? What time is it here?
10.
Yes, okay. All right, so we're gonna do an exercise, and here's the exercise. You are going to say something positive. You're gonna say something positive to each person here. So everybody's gonna get up, we're gonna move around, and you're gonna stand in front of somebody and tell them something that you like about them or that's positive. So come on, get up. Okay, so positive comment. You two, right here, two of you. Positive comment to each other. Okay, two more. Come on, come on. Okay, you're gonna go to someone else. Hey, come on, let's hear it. I'm gonna hear it.
I like your shoes, man.
I love your energy.
Okay, you're gonna do everyone.
Oh, I like how honest you are too.
I like your dress. I like your shirt.
Family first. That's awesome.
My uncle's brand.
Your uncle's brand?
Thank you.
Wow. Do you help with this?
Yeah.
Awesome. So I'd like to help your uncle.
Is that a positive?
All right. Something else. Okay. Come on. Come around and do that with someone else. Come on.
Thank you.
I like your view.
My
You can do me.
Hi, Kayla. I like your outfit.
Thank you.
I like your chain.
Thank you.
Hi. I like your shirt.
Thank you. Hi, Clouds. You're so beautiful, Clouds.
Thank you.
Yes.
Hi.
Oh,
I like your hair.
I love your smile.
Thank you.
Your way.
Thank you.
Hi.
I like your hair.
Thank you.
Thank you. Look at you recording.
I like your style.
My eyes.
And I like your shirt.
What are you interested in?
I think you're a great intern. You're doing so
well. What do you like to do?
Yeah.
Sports.
YouTube. Thank you. And I love it.